Well, Fail Pal, how do I know if my orchid is reblooming? I've seen a lot of Fail Pals that look at this and say, girl, my orchid is making new buds. No, baby, I know that's what we want, but no, that's not how it goes. Okay, I'm gonna give you a couple of examples, Indy, and I gotta let you go. Welcome one and welcome all, baby, to Orchids for Dummies, a place where you can get your life. I am Fal Pal Darrell, and in today's video, I want to share with you ways to bring home a new orchid, avoiding bud blasts, and even some tips and tricks to get that Phalaenopsis orchid to rebloom. Stay tuned. Welcome back. This little darling right here I picked up from the grocery store just a couple of days ago. The first thing when you are bringing it out of the grocery store into outdoors and then into your car, which is at first either cold or hot, and then bringing it home, which is another climate, that right there will stress the plant out. So let's go ahead and assume that this orchid is stressed. So Fal Pal Darrell, what is the best thing to do for a Phalaenopsis orchid that is under stress? That is going to be put it somewhere where it is getting plenty of sun or plenty of light and leaving it alone for a few days. You're going to wait until the orchid shows you it is acclimated. What is acclimation, Fal Pal Darrell? Girl,
thanks for staying tuned. Please like this video. Okay, go ahead and subscribe because you won't find another Fal Pal like me. So check out this beautiful Phalaenopsis orchid. That's a silver vase orchid. Yes, it is. But if you look at the tag, it will let you know it's one of those Phalaenopsis orchids by SV. The leaves are absolutely gorgeous. It appears to be healthy. This orchid was $10, okay, a 3-inch pot. That's what we're working with. I left the plastic on it because this plastic, darling, is going to, all of those cold winds or all of those heat blasts, that's what this is for, to reduce some of that shock, okay? So I left it on here so I can actually let it get acclimated. Acclimation is a plant or a person getting accustomed to their new growing environment. So one of the ways to make sure that the orchid is acclimated is growth, okay? So we're looking for a new leaf or new root or something simple as a bud opening up. This right here is a bud just now opening up. This is another one opening up. That is going to be the first step and the first thing that you can do to get this Phalaenopsis to rebloom. Okay, the second thing is, well, Fal Pal Darrell, where do we place the orchid? How do we place the orchid? Okay, keeping it short and simple. Majority of the times, the blooms are going to be facing towards the sun. Majority of the time, area roots are going to go away from the sun. So that's going to be one of the ways that you're able to tell. And the leaves should be facing you. You see how it's facing me, okay? It's not facing that way. Yes, it's more buds back here. Yes, it's more beautiful. But you want to think about the way that the Phalaenopsis was already growing. You want to keep that type of climate or, you know, living situation up. That is how you are going to get it to rebloom. So it's been 2 days. You want to give it at least 3 days before you start messing with it. Well, Fal Pal, what if it's dry? What if I need to water it? Okay, watering your Phalaenopsis orchids is going to be predominantly a problem for those growers that have their orchids planted in bark. If I look in here, I can see that this is potted into sphagnum moss, which is water and nutrient retentive. Now, this is day two, so I've been already inspecting this, and what I found was some fungus nets inside of this bag, okay? So, in this scenario, you would want to go ahead and repot it, okay? Especially with beautiful blooms like this. I have not seen this before. So this is definitely a Phalaenopsis I want to keep in my collection. So I'm going to do what's best for the orchid. I haven't looked at the roots yet, okay? But I'm pretty sure it needs to be repotted due to the fact that I saw the fungus nets. So those couple of tips and tricks right there are some of the first things that you can do to get your Phalaenopsis orchid to rebloom. This little darling right here has been in bloom all year. These are her old flower spikes right here. She created this offshoot branch right here. Offshoot, you know, that's just a branch on top of another branch. This is the original branch where the blooms just faded recently. But before they faded, she has new blooms already, over 7 buds. So she is a happy camper, okay? So when you get your orchid home, don't worry about fertilizing it. Don't worry about, you know, getting grow lights and all of that thing. The first thing that you want to do, position it in the right way and give it time to acclimate. Once you see buds opening up, okay, and you see or a new leaf or a new root growing, that means that it's acclimated. Then you could go ahead and start examining it, okay? But remember the position that you had it in, because that is what it likes. So that is, giving the orchid what it likes is how you would get it to rebloom. This is another Phalaenopsis that's been in bloom all year as well, okay? So just a preview for videos to come. So you can see right here how this is round. That's just the end of the flower spike. It always has the potential to grow a new bud, but that is not the bud. The bud will actually come out from there. So you will actually be looking, you see this little sheath right here? This is where you would be looking for a new bud to form. Let me show you an example of one that, you know, might be going through that, you know. Like I said, she's already been in bloom, but you can see something is being pushed out of there. Okay, so this is an example of when your Phalaenopsis orchid has the potential to rebloom for you. Okay, right here. This is an example as well, but you can see it's wrinkled, and it also has been like this for several weeks. So that's an indication that it's not going to rebloom. Well, Phal Pals, I gotta go. Okay? And I hope that you have a happy growing. Mama is coming back, and she's coming back soon. Be on the lookout. Ring the bell. Until next time.